I'm going to show you how to edit a wedding ceremony in seconds with AI in Premiere Pro. Literally, I'm going to take an entire wedding ceremony that has multiple cameras, multiple speakers, and multiple sources of audio and take it from looking like this, completely unedited, to this. All of the cuts made, basically ready for you to deliver to your couples as a finished video in a few seconds. This means that if you film weddings, editing the ceremony will be a lot less tedious. And what's better is that if you wanted to sell your couples a standalone wedding ceremony video, which I highly recommend doing, you'll be able to make a ceremony video in a few minutes, and it's like printing money. It's awesome. Here's how it works. To do this, you're going to need to download an extension for Premiere Pro called AutoPod. You may have heard of AutoPod because early in 2023, it took the podcasting world by storm, because this extension will essentially edit a video podcast for you, saving you minutes, if not hours, of tedious work cutting between camera angles. Sorry, AutoPod is not free, but they do offer a 1 month free trial, so you can download this like I did, test it out, and if you like it and it works, then you can keep paying for it once your free trial is up. I'll link to AutoPod down below so you can check it out. Now, as I said, AutoPod was made for editing video podcasts, but whenever I saw it, I realized, wait a second, a video podcast is just a group of cameras and audio recorders that cut from camera to camera, depending on who is speaking. Do you know what else is really similar to that? A wedding ceremony, where you have a group of cameras and audio recorders that cut from camera to camera, depending on who is speaking. And so that got me thinking, could you use AutoPod to edit a wedding ceremony video? And the answer is yes, you can. Here's how to set it up. To start, download AutoPod, install it to your computer, open up Premiere Pro, and then go to the AutoPod extension. But before you can dial in all of these settings, you're going to need to prep your sequence for AutoPod to edit it. This is really simple to do. All you need to do is have the video clips from your cameras on their own video tracks and all of the audio recorders that you used on their own audio tracks. So in this case, I have the camera that I used to film the bride and officiant for the wedding ceremony on track one, and then I have the camera that I used to film the groom on track two. If you have more cameras that you like to use, I know many videographers like to have a wide angle set up in the back as a safety angle, feel free to put that camera on its own track as well. And in addition, if you're a wedding filmmaker that likes to roam with one camera and film lots of different things, in this situation, AutoPod isn't really going to work the best for you, and you're going to need to add those roaming camera clips in manually. But thankfully, that shouldn't be too much work because AutoPod is still already doing 80 to 90% of the work. Likewise, I also have all of the audio recorders that I used on their own tracks as well. So I had a microphone on the bride on audio track one, a microphone on the groom on audio track two, and a microphone on the officiant on audio track three. Please note that if you are recording from something like the house audio where you plug into the venue's soundboard and use a microphone that records the officiant and the couple talking and they're all mixed into one audio file, in that case, AutoPod is not going to work because it requires all of the audio sources to be separated on their own audio tracks. Next, you need to have all of your audio and video clips synchronized so that they're all lined up and playing back at the same time. You can see here on the waveform that this is all perfectly matching up here because I have synchronized it. If you aren't sure how to synchronize all of your audio and video clips, I have a tutorial about how to do that using the tools in Premiere Pro. I will link to that tutorial up in the corner and down in the video description. In this case, I've already synchronized all of these audio and video clips, so the last thing that you will need to do before you dive into AutoPod is you need to make sure that all of your video clips start at frame zero at the beginning of your timeline. This means that if one of your clips is longer than the other, which is definitely most likely to occur because this is a wedding ceremony with multiple cameras spaced all around a ceremony site, you are going to need to shorten your longest clip so they're the length of your shortest clip. Do not worry though, this is not destructive. If you're like, Matt, I have important footage in these earlier portions of some of these clips, don't freak out. You'll be able to go back and extend these clips after AutoPod does its thing and makes its cuts. So in this case, we just need to do a little bit of tweaking here because the video clip on track two is longer than the clip on track one. We'll also select all of our audio tracks, bring those over, go back into the beginning, press the delete key, which is going to line up everything. And now all of our clips start at frame zero, right at the beginning of our timeline. Let's get into AutoPod then. This is super simple to set up. You are first going to go up here to layout info. And for cutting method, you have the option of either standard or enable/disable. You're going to want to select enable/disable because what this means is that AutoPod is not going to delete your video clips. It is only going to disable them if they are not being used. The reason this is important is that this is a wedding video. And if AutoPod gets a little overzealous, you may want to re-enable some of these clips to bring back the footage that is disabled. I find that that can just make the edit quicker. Next, you have the option to select your wide shot frequency. And this is another area where podcasts line up well with wedding ceremonies, in that both podcasts and ceremonies are videos where filmmakers like to have a wide safety angle, either of a group of people speaking for a podcast or a wide angle setup in the back of a wedding ceremony, just in case some of the other angles get blocked. In this demo here, I do not have a wide ceremony angle, so I'm going to ignore this setting and just leave it on medium. But if you have a wide angle ceremony shot that you want to use, this wide shot frequency setting is going to enable you to tell AutoPod how often you want to cut to that wide ceremony angle. Next, you're going to select how many people you have speaking during the wedding ceremony. Spoiler, this is oftentimes going to be three people comprised of the officiant as well as the couple. In my case for this video, I have a bridegroom and officiant, so I'm going to select three speakers. And then for cameras, I'm going to tell AutoPod that I have two cameras. You can choose up to 10 though, so if you're going really crazy with a ton of angles for your ceremony, you should still be able to make this work. After you choose these settings, you have some advanced settings that you can tweak that will basically help you set how often you want AutoPod to cut from one person speaking to another. By default, having delay cuts set to 0.1 seconds and ignore cuts less than set to 1 second should work well. But if you're noticing that AutoPod is getting really zealous in how much it's cutting between people, especially if, for example, the reason that it's cutting so much is because, let's say, the bride is crying or the groom is breathing heavily, so it's cutting back to them and just showing them like ugly crying or something like that, you can then choose to ignore cuts and you can extend this to be even longer. Maybe from 1 second to 2 or 3 seconds, and seeing if that's going to help remove some of those unwanted cuts. Almost done. You now need to go down here and label your audio track so AutoPod knows who is speaking. In this case, the bride's microphone is on audio one, so I'm going to label this bride, the groom is on audio two, and the officiant is on audio three. So we're going to enter all three of those labels there. Now, in a perfect world, you would have a separate camera angle for all three people in the ceremony, but unfortunately, things don't always work like that. In the case of this wedding, I had one angle that stayed on the groom the entire time, but my other angle went back and forth between the officiant whenever they were speaking and the bride whenever she was saying her vows. Thankfully, AutoPod can work with even more complicated camera setups like this. By using this tag speaker section, I'm going to click on video one and I'm going to tell AutoPod by scrolling down here that they're actually the bride and the officiant on video track one. And for video track two, it is the groom. Notice here that you also have a lot of other combinations to choose from, including all speakers, which you can consider that wide shot that's going to affect how often it's cutting to that wide angle. With that, we have now dialed in all of our wedding ceremony settings. AutoPod does give the option to save all of these settings that we've made here as a preset by going up here and clicking new. And this is great if you are filming, say, a podcast and you always have the same people speaking with the same camera angles, etc. But in our case, we are editing a wedding ceremony, which is going to be dynamic and changing every single time that you film a new wedding. So I don't really see much value in creating a preset, so we're not going to do that. What we are going to do, though, is pretty darn magical, because it's finally time to click this Create Multicam Edit button at the bottom and let AutoPod do its thing to our wedding ceremony. Let's do it. Here's where it gets crazy. Look how fast that is. Oh my goodness. All right, it's done. Okay, AutoPod has now gone through and made camera cuts between every single person speaking, enabling and disabling video tracks, and let's see how it did. As you can see here at the start of the wedding ceremony, it was mostly focused on video track one because this was the video track that had the officiant in it. So we have some nice moments here of him speaking, going through.
It makes you feel complete.
And then occasionally it would cut to an angle of the groom reacting, which looked really good. Notice here with the audio that it's usually cutting to the groom in moments where the officiant is not speaking. So whenever he pauses here, for example, cuts to the groom, then back to the officiant. I don't think these cuts are bad because it can oftentimes be boring to just keep the camera angle on the person speaking the entire time. So I'm going to leave these cuts as they are. Next, here's where things get even more impressive because we're going to go to where the bride and the groom are giving their vows. In this case, AutoPod recognizes that the groom is now speaking, so it's going to cut to his angle and it's going to just hang out on him as he is giving his vows. Can you see how much time AutoPod is already starting to save you? This is like a 20-minute long ceremony and all of these cuts were made in a few seconds. All right, now it's time to blow your mind because here is the groom giving his vows, but there's also a moment where the bride starts to speak a bit and give some commentary. I want you to watch how AutoPod handles this.
bunnies, leopard gecko, and a precious puppy.
We can get two more. Nearly.
No. You take care of them all so well, and I love you for that.
Do you see that? It shows the groom speaking, but then it recognizes that the bride is speaking. It cuts to her, then back to the groom. This is so great, and is pretty much exactly what I would have done if I was editing this ceremony by hand. It hit the right humor beats, and then just went right back to the groom speaking. Overall, I feel like AutoPod got this entire edit about 90% of the way there. And while I feel like there are a few tweaks that I'm going to need to make, this is still saving so much time. Specifically, as far as tweaks that need to be made, I want you to notice that at the end of the ceremony here, AutoPod got a little cut crazy. It was like, okay, we got the groom, they're kissing, which is great. But then it started to cut back and forth a lot. And you can see how often it's cutting here. And one reason that's happening is that AutoPod is just analyzing the audio and it's choosing the loudest audio to cut to. And in this case here, there's so many people cheering and clapping. It doesn't really know what to focus on. It's like, okay, either one of these camera angles, people being loud constantly, so just cut back and forth quickly. In short, AutoPod doesn't know that it's actually editing a wedding ceremony, and this is a joyous moment, and it should hold on to each of these clips for a while. Maybe someday it will understand that it's a wedding ceremony in the future, but for now, it's just focusing on the audio volume. Also, remember how I said earlier that we would need to shorten these clips down to make them be at the same starting point? Well, what's great is we can zoom out here, go back to the beginning. I can press Control A to select all the clips, drag them over, and then select the first clip, drag it out, re-enable it, and ta-da, now we have this entire clip. If we had any moments from the beginning that we needed to access, can easily do that because AutoPod is non-destructive in how it is editing these video clips. And that's how you edit a wedding ceremony in seconds with AI in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now I hear you already saying, Matt, can I do this in DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut? Unfortunately, at the time of recording this video, AutoPod is only available in Premiere Pro. But leave a comment below if you'd like to see them added to one of these other programs. Also, while you're down there in the video description, I've put a link to a free guide that I've put together called Edit Videos Like a Pro. This guide is going to show you some of the most important things that I've learned as a video editor that took me literally years to learn, and it's going to save you a ton of time. This guide is completely free, and you can download it at the link down below. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.